Hello folks, in this video we'll talk about size of EC2 instances. We refer to them as instance type. So in AWS, you'll find various families, for example general purpose like T2, M4, compute optimized something like C4, memory optimized like R4, GPUs like P-series, memory optimized as X-series, etc. So basically these families of instances are to group similar kind of instances and similar kind of use cases. So for example, we've got a T2 family, and the T2 family have got multiple members like nano, micro, small, large. So as the name suggests, they differ in the size, their capacity, their CPU power, their RAM, their network performance, etc. So again, while launching an EC2 instance, you have to select these instance types based on your use case. You need to have an understanding about what kind of instance type family is most suited for what kind of use case. Now, AWS recommends that you can start with a small instance to begin with. As and when your need increases, you can move to higher instance sizes as well. So in short, you can see that D family is for dense storage, where the normal use case is file servers, data warehousing, Hadoop-based cluster, etc. R series is for memory optimized use cases like memory intensive applications, databases, etc. T series and M series is for general purpose use cases. G is for graphics intensive applications. I is for high speed storage, for example, NoSQL databases, data warehousing, etc. In F series, the hardware itself has, in F series, it's using hardware acceleration of your code and providing field programmable gate array for your applications. P2 and P3, these kind of instances are basically for GPUs. So when you have got applications like machine learning applications, very high compute intensive other applications, Bitcoining mining, etc., then you'll go for these kind of instances. X1, etc. are memory optimized families where you have use case of say using SAP HANA, Apache, Spark, distributed programming system. So from time to time, AWS keeps launching new instances for new use cases. You can go to their documentation page, and that is the best source of existing families and existing instances along with what is the best use case for these instances. So let's go there. To find that out is very easy. You can just Google for AWS instance types. Normally, the first link that you'll get is for AWS documentation about these instance types. So here you can see they've got general purpose, compute optimized, memory optimized, accelerated computing, storage optimized, etc. So under these categories, there are various families. You can go and find it out in more detail here. For example, T2 instance, they are burstable performance instances that provide a baseline level of CPU performance with the ability to burst above the baseline. So basically they are general purpose computing instances. Based on your case, there are multiple models here, T2.nano, T2.micro, T2.small, up to T2.xlarge. So the relative CPU capability is provided by vCPU, virtual CPUs. This is basically a unit provided by AWS to compare the strength of CPUs across multiple instance types. CPU credits per hour is basically their mode of tracking that how much CPU resource you are consuming per hour. So basically you can keep on collecting CPU credits if you are using the same less CPU utilization, and you will be spending these CPU credits when you are using CPU more than a threshold limit. So CPU credits that you accumulate, that is also different for different instances. Here you can see under memory, you can see the how much RAM you are getting. This is given in GB. And on the storage, you can find out that what is the storage type available for this instance type. So there are basically two types of storage, EBS and instance storage. All these models, they support storage of EBS type only. We'll talk about that in our volumes and snapshot video. So similarly, under general purpose itself, you have got M5, you have got M4. You can find out the feature of them. You can find out the use case here. So this is the best source of information about which use case needs which kind of instance type. So I strongly recommend you to go to this particular page and find out best instance type for your use case. You can go through various tabs and browse use cases and features of these various instance types. So now again, the pricing of your EC2 instance will depend on what instance type you are using. So be sure about the price of instances before selecting instance type. Especially if you are using free users tier, then as of now, in May 2018, AWS allows only T2.micro under free tier program. So if you are using a free tier account and you don't want to get charged, always select T2.micro, which is giving you one virtual CPU and 1 GB of RAM with EBS as storage volume. T2.micro is sufficient for your learning purposes. If you need higher capacity of instances for, say, running machine learning based applications or other very memory optimized or compute intensive programs, then you have to go and use other instance type as well. So that's all we have in this particular video. We'll continue learning about EC2 instance in the next video. Thank you for watching.